Hi everyone, welcome to Intentional Living Space. I'm your friend Purvi and I make weekly videos on minimalism, self-development and anything that can get you notches higher. If you're following me for a while, I'm sure that you have hit the bell button and are getting immediate notification for my video. If you're new here, I'm really happy to have you on my channel. I hope that you find value in the content that I present. So friend, today I'm going to be talking to you about a very, very important topic, mostly overlooked by all, which is why do I want to follow minimalism, right? The why aspect of it. What is my final outcome of the practice of minimalism? So if you are intrigued by this, continue watching the video and let's get on to it. So friends, as anyone would say that it is very important to define your objective before, you know, embarking on any important journey. So if you have not decided why do you want to become a minimalist, you will never end up becoming one, and sooner or later you will give up on that journey. So friends, today I'm going to share with you my final outcomes of why I have chosen the journey of minimalism and what do I want to get out of it. Because minimalism is not a destination. It is not like, you know, I have thrown away all my belongings. I'm a minimalist from today. Now what do I do? So it's not that way. Because of minimalism, you can achieve certain results in your life. So I'll help you with mine. The first is, I want to be as intentional as possible with what comes in my life and goes out of my life. Now, this is a very, very broad, you know, outcome that I have designed for myself. So I have broken it down into three parts. Intentionality can be applied to every aspect of your life. It is not necessary that it is only towards the things. But the first is the things. So I would like to, you know, tell you about something known as the Indian clutter scene. Okay, so I grew up in a typical Indian household, and if you know typical Indian households, we tend to keep everything from generations. We don't have a habit of throwing anything. So all of us Indians somewhere are immune to the clutter around us. So you will have parents saying, "Ke, why you bothered this, you know, your grandfather's something, you know, like a memory, we have kept it. It has a storage, we have the storage. Why do you want to throw it?" So there will always be some sort of, you know, something like that in an Indian household where they have kept things from generations, and automatically the youngsters get immune to seeing clutter around them. So when I embarked on this journey of minimalism, I said I am going to be intentional with what comes in my life and what goes out of my life. I don't want to keep it for the, you know, heck of keeping it for some sentimental reason that, you know, I mean, sentimental things can be kept in different ways also, right? So that is my first sub point of the intentionality outcome. The second point is that I want to be intentional with the relationships or the bonds I develop in my life. There is a lot of toxicity around us. There are so many negative people around us, and I want to be intentional with the relationships in my life. I have created a good, a sense of peace of mind for myself, and I don't want to invite the wrong people into it. Now, the third is what I call is information dump. Now, friends, we are living in an extremely fast-paced life. Information flows faster than the speed of light, I can say. We are living in the information dump age. You wake up in the morning, just take your cell phone, scroll through Google, you will see different news coming to you. Open up any app, open up Instagram, open up Facebook, open up anything. You will have ads and, you know, information bombarded onto you. If you are not intentional with the information you consume, I will tell you this, you will have serious mental health issues. I'm being very plain and simple around here, but this is the truth. You cannot consume all the information that is thrown out to you. Somewhere you have to be intentional about what goes inside your mind. Friends, this is a very, very important topic, and somewhere intentionality and minimalism helps you to curb this overdose of information. So that's about the first outcome that I want to achieve for myself, which is intentional about everything that goes in and everything that goes out of my life. So the second outcome that I see for myself is to save money for my personal goals. Minimalism, frugality, and saving money all go hand in hand. Okay, so actually saving money becomes a byproduct of the process that you're following. So if you are not bringing in clutter and junk in your life, automatically you save your money. So my husband and I have seen a really good result when we, you know, last year I think everyone saved a lot of money. But since the time that we have been intentional about our purchases, we have seen a very, very good result with the kind of money that is getting saved. And believe it or not, friends, accept it or not, money is required at various stages of our life. It is the most important energy that we can have in our life. Money can be required for our personal goals like travel. It can even be required for further education. Somebody wants to, you know, save up for their child's education or their wedding expenses, or it can be required for starting a business. It can be required for retirement fund, for emergency fund, for hospitalization. These are the real realities of life, right? And if we are going to waste our money and, you know, just getting attracted by a marketeer's trap or consumeristic world, then we will not have money left to fulfill our personal goals. So my second outcome which I expect out of minimalism is save enough money to spend it on my personal goals, right? Now the third outcome is fairly straightforward, which is to create time for pursuing my passions. It is very easy to, you know, go in the whirlwind of life where you are stuck with so many unwanted tasks and events and people and things. So minimalism is a great, great tool if you want to focus on yourself, if you want to create time for focusing on what fuels your happiness. I love reading, writing poems. I love writing articles. I love to even watch good influencers, and even working on my YouTube channel is one of my passions. And because I am doing this minimalist, you know, way of life, I have found time to juggle a full-time job and to support this channel. So friends, in a nutshell, this was my outcomes which I expect out of minimalism. I hope that you liked it. If you did, give a thumbs up. I'm waiting. Give it right now. And I will see you again next week. Let me know what are your outcomes, because I'm sure all the people watching here are intrigued by it or want to start it. Please note down your whys. Why do you want to do it? If you're comfortable to share, let me know in the comment section below. Why do you want to do it? And I will see you again next week. Till then, subscribe to my channel and like and share this video with maximum friends. Bye-bye.